Hi, welcome back to the Shtick. I have a couple of guys here who are also heroes. In fact, they're creating heroes in their own way by being heroes as examples, because I think being a personal trainer or a coach is the greatest achievement you can actually perform for other people. It's all about setting examples. And I have in the studio with me Paul Glezer.
How are you, Henry?
Good, and Daniel Norich.
Great to be here, Henry.
Hey, guys. You have got a shtick.
That we do.
Yeah?
Yeah, we certainly do.
We'll start with you, Paul.
Well, look, Hero was born. It's, as you mentioned, Daniel and I's origins are from the physical training world. And we both became fathers a number of years back, and throughout our own personal journeys, my personal journey was that I noticed a lot of my friends, as we were talking off air, a lot of my friends started to drop the ball when they became fathers and their health began to take a back seat. And given that my background's in the health world, I never thought that this would happen to me, but it actually did. And it's one thing to know certain things about a healthy body and a healthy mind, but to actually act on it when the times gets a little bit tough, I felt like I did drop the ball, and hence Hero was born. I needed accountability, I needed support in a busy lifestyle to be able to help myself, to help my family, and Daniel and I joined forces to be able to take that next step in the right direction, to be able to support dads, not just physically, but in a mental and emotional space as well.
And in a holistic kind of style.
Without a doubt, yes. Hero really, really just extended itself holistically to more than just exercise and nutrition, but lifestyle has become a really big focus for us, being able to understand how to create healthy habits and to be able to do them over and over and over again, so you can kind of consistently support that positive momentum.
Wonderful. And Daniel, what's your background?
Also been in the health and fitness space for the last 10 years, and I think things started to change in the nature of the work that I wanted to do when in 2016 my wife and I brought a beautiful boy into the world, and unfortunately at 7 weeks old he passed away. And during that period I lived at the Royal Children's Hospital with my wife Romy, and we spent most of our days and evenings together with Bodie, our son. And during that period, which was a very tragic circumstance, quite heartbreaking and very sad, I used my kind of skills and experience in just learning how to still show up as a family man, but also take care of myself. Mm. And I spent time during that 7 week period just being in the gym, out in nature, taking time to care for myself so I could show up for my son and be there for my wife and just be there for the wider family too. And during that period, I started to see I was going through a circumstance of suffering and challenge, and how many countless other dads and other people go through that too. And so for me, that's where the journey of Hero really came to life. And then fortunately, Paul and I crossed paths a few years later, and we both had experiences to share, and we've both known each other from being in the health space for quite some time. And it was just natural that we could come together, collaborate, and help other men who are struggling to find the time and energy to prioritize themselves, because that's the biggest challenge.
I think a lot of people realize that statistics of marriage are very tragic in themselves. From my experience, I've had too many friends who have separated after the first or second or even the third child. It's the whole pressure, the dynamics is really, really challenging. Mm. And is that what you do? You create a way of for people to be able to see in a better light the real situation.
You're absolutely right. The dynamics change, like, you know, your reality as a father is very, very different to what it was pre-father. I think there's a lot of experience of loss. Now, people experience loss in many different ways, but what I experienced was loss of certain independence, especially at the beginning of becoming a father and transitioning into that period. And what we've found is in supporting our dads is just being there to be able to have support. With coaches and with a community of people who are looking to move in the same direction can be such a powerful shift and such a powerfully supportive mechanism for dads trying to achieve these goals.
And how do you do it, Daniel? What's the process?
Well, I mean, essentially, we've got this platform where we offer one-on-one customized support. So we develop a strength and health program that supports busy dads to get the strength training they need to be robust, active fathers so they can pick up their kids and get into a nice squat position and feel like they've got the strength to lift the kids up. But also mobility, flexibility. So holistic in the nature that fitness doesn't look like just doing bicep curls. It's a lot more than that. So we integrate some yoga into that as well. Then a simple nutrition plan and then lifestyle support with how to dial in a good morning routine, an evening routine, how to stay on track when there's no momentum, how to stay on track when you're feeling like you could just keep going, and just finding that balance. And it's all about efficiency, because if you're time poor, there's always an excuse to not do the self-care work. And we want to make it as easy as possible. So everything's delivered online, can be done at home, can be done in the office, can be done on the side of the road. We want to make it like it impossible to have an excuse.
Is it a one-on-one program, more or less?
Yeah, it ultimately is. There are aspects of it where the exercises or the strength training routine is delivered through our own app.
And what's the website?
So the website is www.hero.cm, and that's where we have an abundance of information that you can access about what it is that we do, and but ultimately it will also take you on a journey to be able to jump on a phone call, and Daniel and I are always available to be able to have a phone call with anyone who just wants to talk about where they're at in health, what challenges they're experiencing, and you know, basically trying to path or carve out a road to being able to be fitter, healthier, stronger in body and in mind. So the exercises are completed through the app, but we have a very, very relentless philosophy on support when it comes to the hero team being available constantly for each individual dad, and being able to set up a communication channel between myself, Daniel, and each individual dad, but then also being able to lend the access to the community of all other dads, because we've found that that community of dads being able to understand that they're all in the same place, trying to move in the same direction, is a really powerful supportive mechanism to get them moving as well.
And I think the most important thing is getting good habits. And what sort of habits do you teach, Daniel? What are the things that really people need to, you know, because it's very easy to lose the thread, you know?
Absolutely. It's easy to drop the ball, especially if you're busy, and we're all busy, but we just want to make sure that that's never an excuse for not taking good care of yourself. So simple things like, what time do you get up in the morning? Can that be predictable? Can you get up earlier than everyone else in the house to get the work done? And that might be scary for a lot of people, because sleep is so important. So what's the solution? Go to bed a bit earlier.
Yeah.
It's very simple. So it's about... But it's about building habits one day at a time. And if you fall off the wagon, Paul and I are there to support you to just start again. And it's all about resetting and starting again. It's not reset and then drop the ball and then see you later. We make it our mission to just be with you during that journey. And that's why it's the hero's journey. And the journey's not about the destination. It's just showing up one day at a time and building those habits. Water, walking, morning routine, evening routine, short practices that everyone can do really to optimize their body as well as their mind.
Something I've learned lately, and I think it's the most important thing that I've learned, and it's only something that I really have only just recently become more aware of than ever, is to listen. Like if you're with your partner and you're listening, and you can actually concentrate on listening to your partner and listening to each other, I think that makes such a difference. Doesn't it?
Yeah, it's a hell of a skill.
It's the number one thing, I think.
It's much more powerful than talking.
And yeah, exactly.
It's much more challenging than talking.
Talk less, listen more. I think that's really summed it up. But guests I've always had, this is show number 674 on the Shtick.
Bravo.
And every guest I've ever had on is passionate and proactive. And really has an aim. And I think you guys, as soon as I found out what you did, Paul, I really thought this is Shtick worthy.
It was Shtick worthy.
You like that?
The very first thing that came up was Shtick worthy. And I love it.
We'd like to tell more people about what these guys do, because I really believe in it, you know, and they believe in what they're doing. And I think that is more important than anything else. You've really got a Shtick. and you've got a direction. I think it's very important to have direction. And you've put yourselves out there. You've put yourselves into a position where you want to help people. And I admire that. Thank you very much for doing what you do.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for having us.
It's a pleasure. And next week we're doing more Shtick, because that's what we do.
Love it.
Bring it on.
More Shtick-worthy content.
And we'll sing. We'll go out with a song.
Great.
Do you know We Could Be Heroes?
Should we start? Do you want to hold the beat?
Yeah. I should have bought my bow t-shirt.
Yeah, I know. Both these guys are musicians. They have a drummer and a bass player. And I know David Bowie is one of my heroes. I went to his exhibition in...
So did I.
You went to that
exhibition? With his costumes?
Yeah. Oh, wasn't that the most amazing exhibition
Incredible.
You've ever seen?
Unbelievable. So cool.
He was the man for all seasons. He was the... What do you call that? He's a Renaissance man.
Yeah, he was prima donna.
Because he did everything. There's nothing he couldn't do. Movies, poetry... singing.
He's the embodiment of a hero.
He really
does it all.
And we could be heroes.
Just for one day.
Yes, we could be heroes. Not just for one day. Forever and ever. All right, thanks, guys.
Thanks, Henry.
We'll be out of here. And we will go out with a little bit of David Bowie, maybe.
Ooh.
Or somebody's version. I don't know what the... We have a bit of a problem with... What do you call it? Trademarks?
Trademarks. We'll get like some klezmer version.
An obscure version. All right. We'll see you next week for more Shtick. And thank you both very much.
Thanks, Henry.
Thanks, Henry.